instant and it's cool to the touch. And when you're cooking on induction, the outside is still cool, which means if you spill anything on it, particularly if you're doing jam or hot sugar syrups, it doesn't burn on like you get with hot plate or if you get with gas. So it's much easier to clean. Again, when you say it's cool to the touch, you have to have special pans, but ferrous metal pans, which are magnetic. So in order to know exactly if your pans fit onto the induction, stick a fridge magnet to the base. And if you stick a fridge magnet to the base, then again, and it sticks, it's suitable for induction. The pans that have the red dots or the brass middles don't work on induction. And the pans that are glass or aluminium don't work either. The Lecoultre will work. So if you have the Lecoultre at home, then they will work on induction. They work beautifully. Very quick, very fast. It's faster than boiling a kettle. You've boiled a pan of water on here and put your kettle on, and I've tested this at home because my kettle is quite near to my induction. This boils faster, particularly if you use your power boost function. On ours, they come with P functions, which is power boost, and they come with an L function, which is a low function, which means something like a stew or casserole or a soup that you've cooked and just want to keep it very low or very warm but not cooking it anymore, you put on a low power. Or the power boost, it accentuates it, and literally a couple of minutes of the water or pan of water for your pasta will be coming to the boil very quickly. So that's two functions, along with the suspension control that we have on our inductions. We also have timers on our induction hobs as well, which means that you can set each heating zone, or in fact your flexi area, to become on a timer. So if you were doing a spaghetti bolognese and you wanted to go onto the phone or someone came to the door, you could set that to simmer to reduce your sauce for 20 minutes on level 3, and you could put a timer on that. So you can walk away knowing that that will be safe and be simmering on level 3 for 20 minutes while you're on the phone or talking to somebody, and then after 20 minutes that induction plate that you've set on a timer will switch itself off. And most of our top-of-the-range induction hobs now have timers on them as well. So, controllability, easy to clean, very streamlined, and again, the speed of them, and the fact that they're cool to the touch as well. Things don't burn on them very easily. And again, with the fingerprints, e-cloths are the best way to clean an induction hob. Just moisten your e-cloth, you get rid of all the fingerprints, and these are a very good thing to invest in for your ovens as well. So your fingerprints on your ovens and your smudgy finger, generally get the black and the stainless steel, e-cloth is the best thing. You don't need to use any chemicals, you just moisten them and just wipe them over. They go in the washing machine, they wash up to 300 times because they're impregnated, you just keep reusing them. We sell them through the website. We've got an enormous array of our own cleaners, which we recommend for our own products. But again, the e-cloths you can purchase Tesco, John Lewis. They all sell them now. Great for your kettles, your toast, well, your taps. I've got one in the bottom as well for doing the taps. And your little stainless steel, so very good for too.